Next topic is how to learn one rule. So to learn one rule, we are going to study the topic that is general to specific beam search. In general to specific beam search, we are moving from the general hypothesis to a specific hypothesis. The general to specific search or a general to specific beam search, it is performed with an high accuracy. The general to specific beam search here, it is going to perform an learn one rule algorithm. So learning in one rule algorithm, it has been performed by using a greedy search with no backtracking. So what is meant by greedy search or greedy depth searches? We are going to consider a complete database. In a complete database, there will be a training examples. So each row of a training examples, it is considered to be as in one instance here. So if I consider a first row of a training example, as per the sequential covering algorithm along with the greedy search, so first row of a training example, it has been considered. As we all know that a greedy search, it is performed in order to get an optimal solution, that is in order to get the local minimum. So whereas a local minimum along with the sequential searching, if it is performed, so each row it has been considered of a training example, and in this row it is going to find the local minimum or the best fit hypothesis. So local minimum in the sense where the error will be less. So in a sequential covering, so the first row it has been covered along with the greedy search, means finding the optimal solution. In the it is going to move to the second row of a training example. When it moves to the second row of a training example, it is going to remove the first row from its memory. So in the second row, again the local minimum along with the best fit hypothesis, it has been found out. Again, when it moves to the third row, the second row, it is going to be eliminated from the memory of a machine. So this is known as a greedy depth. The greedy depth or a greedy search, it is nothing but finding an optimal solution at each stage, or it is nothing but finding the local minimum and at the last finding the global minimum. The global minimum is the one where the error is zero. When the error is zero, the predicted value, it is equal to an actual value. So when the predicted value, it is equal to an actual value, we say that it is a best fit. So in a general to specific algorithm, so the general to specific beam search algorithm is the one where it is a learn one rule algorithm, where you're going to find out a single rule by considering a sequential covering and along with a greedy search. So where you're going to perform the local minimum in each and every row or in each and every training example, step by step. So that is a general to specific beam search. Here the best possible condition is selected. Here the beam search algorithm is used, in which the algorithm maintains the list of k best candidates at each step rather than the single best candidate. So means for each step, in the sense for each training example or of a row, it is going to find out the k best candidates. K best candidates means k best hypothesis with the local minimum it is going to be considered. So now what is meant by beam search? The beam search, it is nothing but it is an heuristic algorithm. So where it is going to perform the greedy search step by step with the reduction in the memory. So that is known as a beam search algorithm. So in a beam search algorithm with a greedy search, it is going to find out the k number of best candidates in each and every training example. This k value can be anything depending upon the database that is considered by the user. So instead of a single best candidate at the finally, so it is going to find out k best candidate at each and every row rather than single best candidate at the final stage. Here all the successors are considered at each step. let's see the example of an general to specific hypothesis. So this is an example of an general to specific hypothesis or general to specific beam search. Here we have considered the decision tree. The decision tree, it is first analyzed by an machine, and later it is going to translate this decision tree into an if-then rule. So this is a type of an if-then classification of an learning set of rules. So let's see the database for this first. So this is a database of a play tennis. So here the concept is a play tennis. So here this is a database. It consists of these attributes. So day, outlook, temperature, humidity, wind and play tennis are the attributes. Whereas D1, D2 up to D14 and sunny, overcast, rainy, all these are the attribute values. So for this database, we have returned the decision tree already. So how to write the decision tree? It is being taught in the class. So this is a decision tree for this particular database. We have returned the decision, arrived at the final decision tree based on the calculation of an entropy and the gain. So now this decision tree of this database, it is converted into the form of a rule. So the decision tree, it is converted in the form of an if-then rule. So what is an if-then rule means? So the machine is going to consider the decision tree first. So for that decision tree, it is going to write it in terms of an if-then rule. So let's see it. If then play tennis equal to S. This is the final target concept. So if you want a person to play the tennis, what are the conditions that is present in the table? It has been considered. If the wind equal to weak, then play tennis is yes. So you have to compare this with the database that has been present here. So if the person has to play the tennis, then the wind condition has to be weak here. That is written here. So if wind equal to weak, then play tennis is yes. If the wind is strong, then the play tennis is no as per the database. So let's see that. If the wind condition is strong, then the person is not playing the tennis. So that is written here. Next condition, the humidity is chosen. Now in humidity, we have two conditions, that is either high or normal. So let's see it. If it is yes, the humidity is high. So let's see it. If the humidity is normal, then play tennis is yes. Yes, if the humidity is normal, then the play tennis is yes. If the humidity is high, then play tennis is going to be no. That is written here. So and this next condition, the temperature, next is outlook. It is chosen and it is written here. Now, it is chosen and it is written. That's why the dots is mentioned here. Now, if I choose the humidity as one of the best rule when compared to all the other rules here. So, humidity is considered as the best rule here in the first case or in the first row. Next, in humidity, we are going to compare it again. If humidity is normal, and if wind is weak, then the person can play tennis, yes. So if the humidity is normal, if the wind is weak, then the person can play tennis, yes. Next again, if the humidity is normal and the wind is strong, then no. Now if the humidity is normal, the wind is strong, yes. You have a condition for yes, the person can play.